Hey there, thank you for joining me. Today, I'm discussing all the benefits of a federal GS job. If you're new here, please click subscribe. Now, let's get started. So you might be wondering, why do people pursue a federal government job in the first place? This is especially so in the military and veteran community. You might notice that there are certain populations that seem gravitated towards attaining a GS federal job. This could be from a continued desire to serve, or the similarities between certain departments and the military, or it could be from the benefits that a federal government job offers you. Number one, pension. There are not many companies that offer a pension today. In fact, only 15% of Fortune 500 companies offer a traditional pension plan to its employees. Most companies choose to offer a 401k plan instead, where your retirement is largely dependent on the ups and downs of the stock market. Much like a military pension, there's a sense of financial security that comes with a guaranteed pension that is not associated with the financial markets. It is also possible to receive both a military and government pension and Social Security, all three concurrently. The current average federal employee annual pension for this year is $27,000. Also, if you served in the military and did not retire, you can buy back your time, and that time can be used towards your federal government pension. Number two, TSP matching. Now, TSP is the Thrift Savings Plan. It's much like a 401k. This benefit is tied directly to the financial markets, and it will be in addition to your pension. You are able to select what type of funds you want to invest in, whether it's equities, bonds, or whatever your preference is. You can stick with the default setting, or you can customize it to your liking. Not only can you routinely contribute to this plan, but the government will match your contributions up to 5%. For example, if you are a GS-14, Step 3 in Austin, Texas, you contribute $6,000 a year to your TSP. The federal government will then match with an additional $6,000. That's a $6,000 on top of your salary. So now it's essentially free money. The average TSP balance for all federal employees this year is $164,000. Number three, leave. Annual and sick leave. The federal government leave is generous by most standards. For employees with less than 3 years of service, you will earn 4 hours per pay period, or about 2 weeks of leave per year. If you have greater than 3 years of service, but less than 15, you are entitled to 6 hours per pay period, or about 3 weeks of leave a year. And if you have 15 years or more, then you're entitled to 8 hours per pay period, which comes out roughly to 4 weeks of leave per year. Now, sick leave is in addition to the annual leave, and it's about 2 weeks every year. So if you combine your annual leave and your sick leave together, for most federal employees, they have the ability to take over a month off each year. Sick leave also includes if you have medical appointments or if your family has medical appointments and you have to take them. So consider that also. Number four, paid federal holidays. There are now 13 federal holidays that you will be paid for without working as a federal employee. These are on top of the already generous leave policies that I mentioned. Most departments observe all 13 federal holidays, and you will be off with pay to enjoy these holidays. This also includes the newly formed holiday, Juneteenth, which is June 19th. If the holiday is on a weekend, Saturday or Sunday, the federal department will either recognize it on a Monday or a Friday, which ends up creating a nice 3-day weekend. Number five. Work-life balance. You can have a dependable, consistent schedule in the federal government. Most jobs allow you to pick your working hours and days. There are also plenty of teleworking opportunities where you can work from the comfort of your own home. For most departments, weekends are yours, and you don't have to deal with being on call at any hour of the day, much like you did when you were in the military. Number six, lower insurance rates. We're talking about health, vision, and dental. Insurance is a large expense. Thankfully, a lot of the costs are lower than many private sector options. Your agency will generally pay about 70 to 75% of the premium of your insurance plan, meaning that a plan that would normally cost $1,200 a month would only cost you roughly $300 a month. Number 7, advancement opportunities and the ability to relocate. There are plenty of jobs that are considered laddered positions, where after 12 months, you move up to the next grade. An example is a GS-11/12/13, where after 2 years of acceptable experience, you would move from 11 to 12 to 13. Also, federal government jobs are located all over the country. And not only that, there are plenty that exist throughout the world. At the time of this recording, this video, there are 312 jobs in Germany, 122 jobs in Italy, 260 jobs in Japan, and 27 jobs in Spain. Finally, in my experience, I have been consistently working for the federal government going on 3 years now. Before transitioning to the federal government, I was a master sergeant in the United States Army, working at a university within an ROTC program. I am convinced that working for the government is an incredible opportunity, which offers great benefits and opportunities. And that wraps up my video on the GS job benefits. If you can think of any other benefits, or if you have any questions or comments, please leave them down below. If you like this video, please click like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Thank you for watching.